Zero, that's our friend. Yes, to a mathematician this is a number, but it wasn't always obvious.
Math existed to do financial transactions, to sell sheep, to buy copper things, whatever. And you would use coins and there would be values to the coins. So you would say this costs £5.20 or whatever. You don't do any trading with the number zero. I've got no sheep here. Oh, I'm going to buy no sheep. I'll give you no pounds. It doesn't make any sense. So there was no need for shopkeepers to invent the number zero.
They had the idea of five cows, but the idea of five, not so much. The idea of fiveness, they didn't quite understand. So a number like zero, which is the absence of, well, whatever, cows, whatever it was, made no sense to them. I'm going to ask Brady a question, see if I can catch him out. Brady, is zero an even number?
I think the answer is no, but it feels like it is because it's round.
So this is an interesting... Okay, let me ask another question. Is 16 an even number?
Yes.
Yes. So people have studied this. People have a delayed reaction. People are not sure whether zero is an even number. Now, I can tell you that zero categorically is an even number. It will follow every definition of an even number.
So there was an Indian called Brahmagupta who invented the idea of nothing, not being nothing, but existing as an abstract quantity in the mathematics. Well, then it goes to North Africa, and there's a guy called Al-Khwarizmi, and he writes a book about the art of Hindu mathematics, or reckoning by Hindu mathematics. And that spreads through North Africa to Spain and so forth, and it becomes, they think, Arabic numbers. So you have all the numbers plus zero. That was fine until 1200, when Leonardo of Pisa, also known as Fibonacci, translates this book. It's a wonderful idea, but this is in the period of the Crusades. So people think these are Arabic numbers, not Hindu numbers, because it's come from North Africa. So the Catholic Church objects to this because there are Crusades going on and this is the work of the enemy. So in Florence, for example, they banned the use of this Arabic number zero. And it was thought to be the work of the devil.
Because my definition of an even number is something that can be divided by two.
So Brady just told me an even number is a number that can be divided by two. Well, zero can be divided by two. Zero divided by two is zero. In fact, in that sense, it is the most even number. In ancient times, they had this idea of things being singly even or doubly even. So 12 would be doubly even because you can divide by two and then two again. Well, by that sense, zero can be divided by two and two and two and two. It is the most even number. The correct definition of an even number is it is a multiple of two. Something times two. Something times two. Well, it is. There's no problem with that. It's zero times two. Great. Brady said it had to be divisible by two. Well, that works. Zero divided by two is zero. Okay, so it fits between two odd numbers. That might be a definition for even. Let's do that. There's zero. And over here, that's one. Over here, that's minus one. And then you get two over here, minus two. Perfectly fits. There are some rules for numbers, some arithmetic rules. Two even numbers, if you add two even numbers together, you get an even number. Well, that works. Zero plus four is four, an even number again. That's what we want. We're saying zero is even. It follows every definition. In fact, if it wasn't even, then it would break our rules of arithmetic, which would be a disaster. It is true to say that zero is neither positive or negative. It sits here between the positive numbers and the negative numbers. So it is neither positive or negative.
The discovery of zero was the most important advance in mathematics of all, because it made mathematics capable of being understood by everybody. Everybody could do this mathematics.
The Babylonians, the Greeks, they had the idea of a space. So there was a difference between 26, 2 and 6, and 206, 206. They had a space there. They didn't use the symbol zero, but they had a space. It was like more like a punctuation mark. So the Babylonians would understand the difference between 26 and 206, but instead of using the symbol for zero, they would just have a space. However, if they wanted to write 260, 260 was written like this, and to us, that looks like 26. To them, and in context, that would make sense. But they didn't have this idea of zero by itself. In the 9th century, the first instance, or the first recorded instance of zero was found. It was actually found by a gardener keeping track of the number of flowers that his garden would produce. And he used the number 50 as we would recognize it, 50. After that point, they started to experiment with zero. What could it do? If you add zero, it makes no difference. If you times by zero, you get zero. Dividing by zero, that caused them some problems, as it still does today.
In this sense, the mathematical sense, the number zero does not mean nothing. It means a quantity which you can manipulate in the mathematics. And so it's better to call it zero rather than nothing. Nothing is when you're counting. There's nothing there. Zero is the abstract mathematical quantity.
I'm CGP Gray, and my favorite number is zero. I like zero because it's not an obvious number. Right, you can have counting systems where there's one thing, two things, three things, four things, but mathematics existed for a long time without having a zero as part of it. So it's a number, but it also isn't anything in and of itself.